machine. And we look forward to watching him race both those races. But if you weren't able to join us, it was three playoff races that led us to tonight for the season finale. We narrowed the field down to four championship contenders. So let's take a look at how we got here. Something that you mentioned there, yes, we have gotten so far in brake technology, but something that differentiates with late model racing and some of the upper divisions of NASCAR is the ability to choose your manufacturers and who you want to run your brakes. And there's a lot of flexibility in how these teams are able to do that. So it could be a difference of manufacturers of each of these brakes on these teams, or it could just be a matter of handling with these cars. But thanks, Monica. One of the storylines also is Joey Logano. He's rolling off 28th and the farthest back of the playoff drivers. Unfortunately, that's not where you want to start the second round off, but don't worry, he has two wins here at Richmond as well. So it's a driver that we know can make ground through the field, but he's 48 points also to the good. That's a buffer that a lot of these drivers like to rely on. And we also have a special guest down here in Joey Logano's pit. William, you've got the chance to hang out all day with Joey. What's it been like? You think your driver can get the win?
Yes, easily.
There you go, easily. He called it. Joey Logano making his way back to the front of the field and trying to collect another win here at Richmond.
Hannah Newhouse, what's the story?
Brett Moffitt initially was saying that his truck is absolutely out of control loose. They have no grip in that left rear tire, but his crew chief, Scott Zibidelli, said, hold on to it. We feel like the track is going to come to us, and that's exactly what it has. They continually get better as the track starts to heat up and these trucks continue to lay rubber.
He's down here with third place, Chase Elliott. You were up front all day, strong yesterday in practice, and even a strong run in that Xfinity race. What would it have taken for you guys to ultimately get that job done? Lee Pulliam currently sitting second in the late model stock tour points here in the Cars Tour, 17 points behind Bobby McCarty, two races left on the schedule. How do you approach tonight's race? Get out the broom and hand it to Sam Mayer as he sweeps the day here for the K&N East and West combination event at Iowa Speedway. Quickest in practice, quickest in qualifying, and a dominating race performance for you. Talk about your day here at Iowa Speedway and ultimately how you guys got it done today.
And we're going to try and get a word here with Greg real quick. It's been a long time coming. You guys have had a couple bridesmaid finishes. How does it feel to finally get that monkey off your back and get a victory?
Now, you heard it there from the Bear. He said that his teammate has to win. You've been there as a crew chief, but what goes on in a driver's mind? You've been working with William Byron, who's a little bit of a younger driver, and that's the case for a lot of our playoff drivers this evening. What is going through the minds of these drivers? It all comes down to this next race. Thanks, guys. Like you guys can see, pit stops currently underway here for the NASCAR Wheel and Modified Tour. Timmy Solomito, your leader, his team hard at work behind me. They're going to take four tires, fuel, and this is a great opportunity for teams to make any adjustments that they feel they need going into the last half of this race. Hey, race fans, it's race weekend here at New Hampshire Motor Speedway, and we're here in the NASCAR Home Tracks Hub with lots of cool stuff going on. Come out here, check us out in the fan zone. We're giving away a lot of cool stuff, including stickers, tattoos, koozies. We've even got some cool bags on tap. Also, try your hand at NASCAR Heat here on our gaming consoles. Find out who's the best NASCAR driver out of your friend group.